Support for the Nature Museum is provided by Rose Pest Solutions, protecting homes, businesses, health, and the environment since 1860.
Hi everyone, and welcome to a very special episode of Curious by Nature. My name is Seth, and I take care of all the plants that live on the grounds of the Nature Museum. If you've been by our building in the past couple weeks, you might have noticed that things look a little different outside, and today we're going to find out why. A couple of weeks ago, we had the chance to conduct on our grounds what's known as a prescribed burn, and today I'll be answering some of your questions on what that is and why we do it. So first, what was all that smoke? Well, a prescribed burn is a restoration tool that uses fire to ensure a habitat is healthy. Fire helps clear out the plants that grew up over the past year, returning important nutrients to the soil and opening up the prairie for younger plants to emerge. That fire generates the smoke you saw, and you can see the fire left behind blackened earth, creating a clear space for the native plants just beneath the soil to grow. Prairie fires destroy invasive plants, but also unlock key nutrients, space, and opportunities for native grasses and wildflowers. They also eliminate woody plants or saplings that have the potential to turn the sun-loving prairie into a shaded savanna or even a forest habitat. Next question, how do you choose what to burn? We've learned on previous episodes of Curious by Nature that the museum grounds are home to a very unique ecosystem, the tall grass prairie. The tall grass prairie is unique in many ways. It's an ecological hotspot in the middle of the city. It's a snapshot of what the Chicago area looked like for thousands of years, and it's an ecosystem that depends on fire. We maintain this prairie not only as an exhibit for our visitors, but also to provide a home to Illinois native species. So we want to make sure we're providing a healthy habitat, and so prescribed burns are an integral part of our conservation efforts. We're often asked, why burn a prairie? A controlled fire eliminates leaf litter and non-native species to make space for native prairie plants. Blazing star, purple coneflower, and bee balm are among the many species that thrive after a fire and are crucial to pollinators like bees, butterflies, and hummingbirds. Because fire is so critical to this ecosystem, the Nature Museum facilitates a controlled burn every few years to ensure a healthy and thriving habitat for the plants and animals that call this area home. Controlled burns can do in just a few minutes what months of maintenance, labor, and restoration can do. How do plants survive the burn, you might ask? Well, the plants themselves take care of that, since they're already adapted naturally for fires. Many of the native plants found in a prairie have root structures 5 to 15 feet deep beneath the soil, protecting them from the heat and destruction of any fire. And importantly, the growing points of many prairie plants are located beneath the soil, ensuring the plant can regrow after a burn. Many other plants have their growing point on the top of the soil. These plants are often invasive or non-native plants that are easily eliminated during a prescribed burn. Without the competition from these species, prairie plants can thrive. One important question is, how do you make sure that only what needs to burn, burns? A prescribed burn is a fire that is set intentionally in a landscape by professionals during safe and appropriate weather conditions. You can see here how the trained crew works to manage the fire. Crews use fire breaks, wind direction, and water sprayed from backpacks and tanks to keep the fire in place and on the correct course. Crews will also use drip torches, a canister for holding fuel with a narrow spout, so the fire line is incredibly precise. And here's a great question. How long does it take for the grounds to sprout up again with new growth? Prescribed burns happen on the grounds usually every 3 to 4 years, and after a burn, new growth can be spotted in just a few days. Within a few weeks, the burned areas will be virtually undetectable. These green sprouts started appearing within days of the burn, which is exactly what we'd hope to see. Fire is a natural and essential part of the prairie ecosystem. In addition to lightning-caused fires, native people of the Midwest utilized prairie burns for thousands of years to ensure healthy habitats for grazing bison, to clear land for habitation and agriculture, and to control the movements of game animals. Restoration practitioners use similar tactics to ensure the prairies around us thrive and to create healthy and diverse ecosystems that support healthy and diverse wildlife. I hope you enjoyed learning more about a prescribed burn, one of my favorite conservation tools to help restore and preserve a prairie. If you're in Chicago, stop by our museum grounds soon, and you can see the prairie spring back this year. It really does change every single day. If you enjoyed today's episode, be sure to give us a like and subscribe to the Nature Museum's channel so you never miss an update. We'll see you here next time on Curious by Nature.